Today's encouraging word comes out of the book of Luke, chapter 15, verses 1 through 7, dealing with being lost and getting found, dealing with why Jesus is here on earth. Let's get started. Verse 1, then drew near unto him. This is drawing near unto Jesus. Then drew near unto him all the publicans and sinners for to hear him. And the Pharisees and scribes murmured, saying, this man, Jesus, receiveth sinners and eateth with them. And he, Jesus, spake this parable unto them, saying, what man of you, having 100 sheep, if he lose one of them, doth not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after that which is lost, until he find it? And when he hath found it, he layeth it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he cometh home, he calleth together his friends and neighbors, saying unto them, rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep which was lost. I say unto you that likewise joy shall be in heaven over one sinner that repenteth more than over 99 just persons which need no repentance. Okay, so here in Luke 15, verses 1 through 7, we clearly see why Jesus is on earth. It is to convert lost sinners. It is to spread the gospel. It is to go after those that are lost. Here in this parable, he's showing the lost sheep, right? The Bible calls us sheep, like dumb sheep. We don't know what we're doing. We need help. If that's not the truth, I don't know what it is. It true is so true that we are like sheep, and we need to be herded. We need to be put in our place. We need to be guided, and sometimes we need to be chastened. Okay, and so the sheep runs away. One of them runs away, and this person goes out and finds that lost sheep. The shepherd finds the lost sheep, right? And leaving the other ones, comes back with it, rejoicing. I'll tell you something. When I was living in South Carolina, I had two dogs. I still have these two dogs, Jack and Jill, two German Shepherd Chow mixes, the big, burly, fun-loving dogs. The girl had run away. And it was during a thunderstorm. And if you know anything about dogs and thunder, they don't mix. And I'm also finding out that kids actually are pretty afraid of thunder as well. But anyways, dogs don't like thunder, don't like lightning. And I'd asked my vet one time why that was. And they explained that the dog can't quite see where it's coming from. So it hears it very well. It hears the thunder, the lightning, but it can't perceive where it's coming from. So it runs away. And my dog ran away and was gone 17 days. And during that time, man, I was beside myself. I was so sad. Why? Because I thought my dog had died. Okay. So when something is lost, sometimes you feel like it's dead. It's gone. It's dead to you. It's gone. And here in this scripture, we're seeing the sheep is lost. Like, man, okay, we're lost. And then Jesus is going out, leaving the comfort of those that are not lost to find the one that is. And I'll tell you what, after 17 days, we found my dog. I thought it was a miracle. I still can't believe it. She's still got the scars to this day. And I was so thrilled when I saw my dog. I almost shed a tear. My dog recognized me and was so happy to be back. And I literally carried her out and I put her in my car. I never let her go again. Really a blessing to have her back in my life. Here it shows that Jesus is carrying the sheep back, okay? Notice that he's not walking the sheep or telling the sheep where to go. He's carrying the sheep back. So when you're lost and Jesus finds you, he'll carry you back. He'll carry you back to safety. He'll carry you back to that childhood innocence that you once had, to that loving place of security, of safety. That's the good shepherd. That is our Jesus. And here in this great piece of scripture, we see what Jesus does for us by being lost and carrying us back and putting us back into the fold. And then it says here, you'll notice that the angels are celebrating in heaven so much more so than the just persons that are right, that somebody got right, that somebody repented, that somebody accepted Christ. And I love that song "Shout in Time in Heaven" that I hear on the radio sometimes about how people are, how the angels are shouting when people get saved. And man, I picture that when I watch someone accept Christ as their savior, and I know that they did it. You see a change in them instantly, and you can just feel it. You just imagine in heaven just shouting and praising the Lord, and it never gets old. Friend, if you've ever been part of witnessing someone and getting them saved, there's nothing like it. There's absolutely nothing like it. on earth, and you have a part in that person's salvation forever. And so it's a glorious thing. There's a reward in heaven for you for helping lead people to Christ. I'm sure of that. And it's what we're called to do. It's not just a reward. It's what we're called to do. And so we're called to reach the lost. We're called to find that one that's gone away. And sometimes we've got to carry him back in. Sometimes we got to carry the load. And it's a heavy burden sometimes, but that's what we're called to do. And we know that God is the great healer. God's the great physician. God is in control. We're just his servants. We're his hands and feet. So we just need to act by faith and witness to people and bring them to the house of God and bring them to the altar and help them and just be clear witnesses of the gospel of Jesus Christ to them and let the Lord work in their hearts. And if we do that, the angels will be rejoicing in heaven over a lost soul saved. And if we understand that, then we know our purpose and our calling because we see why Jesus came to earth, not to walk around with the just and the righteous just to say, hey, here we are, we're right and everyone else is wrong. No, he came to reach the lost. He came to get those that are out in the wilderness and he came to bring them back. And I'm so glad for that because I was one of those lost sheep and the Lord came and got me. The Lord used people in my life to come and get me. And praise God, I can't tell you how much better my life is now because somebody came and got me. Somebody preached the gospel to me straight. Somebody said, hey, let me walk you down Romans Road. And all those people were given this in their hearts by the Lord. And so let's serve the Lord. Let's go out and get the lost. Let's understand our purpose and our calling. And let's do it all for the glory of God. In Jesus' name, I'll send you another one tomorrow. Amen.